Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash and welcome to my latest model bus review video. Today I thought I'd cover a very nice detailed model, which is the model of the MAN NL202 single decker bus in the 176 scale. The livery is the Cityflyer livery, and in my opinion, it is a very nice livery applied to this model, just like with the prototype. As you may notice, the packaging is of the standard city bus livery that is mimicked on the card sleeve. The model is in the 176 scale, and if we just turn the box around, just to cover the features of the packaging, so please excuse the fingers and the creaking of the plastic, which is rubbing against my fingers as I grip it. Here is the details on the back of the box. The web address is clearly shown there, but I will add a live link to this address in the description on the video. And if I just move my thumb out of the way, here is a picture of the actual bus, which is a dual door model, although as you've just seen, this particular model is a single door variant which runs to the airport from the central district, or at least that's what I believe anyways. So I'm just going to stop the video and remove the packaging, and then I will be back with some close-ups, so stay tuned, I will be back shortly. Welcome back, and I have to say, the detail kind of speaks for itself, and to be utmost truthful, I've never seen so much detail added to a model bus like this one before. So in my opinion, this is equally one of the best model buses for detail that I've covered so far. So to be truthful, it's quite difficult to choose where to start, but I will stick with the protocol and start with the front and near side, just like with the other models I've done. And if we just go into three time zoom, making sure that the camera doesn't blur, I will point out that every single component that you see, from the indicator lights to the door frames, the handrails, the vault, the dashboard, the window wipers, the wing mirrors, and even the glazing, are all separately fitted components. As I've not removed the model from the plinth, I can't state whether this has freewheeling wheels or not, but if it does, that would be a bonus. Although for me, if I do place this on the layout in the future as a static vehicle, I will have to place it near the station on my layout. But anyway, sticking with this model, just going into 6x zoom, whilst maintaining focus, the fleet number is 1569. The destination is A10 to the airport, which is both written in English and Chinese. I'm going to let the detail kind of speak for itself, as there is so much detail to describe, it's kind of hard to know where to start. But just like with most models, you've got the MAN badge. The registration is JL8007. The glazing and the handrails on the doors are all separate fitted components, along with the indicators and all the separate components that you can see in the view as I pan the camera across the model. So I'm just going to zoom out to around 5x zoom to avoid any blurring. Wow. Amazing detail. Apologies for the silence there. I'm quite literally speechless by just how impressive this model really is. If this was a model train that I was reviewing, this would probably be the model bus equivalent of the Backman Blue Pullman in terms of detail. But that's just my opinion. And if I just zoom out, I shall carefully handle this model, so please excuse the fingers whilst I turn the plinth around, and I shall give some views of the side and the rear. But as you may see, the internal seating, along with the backs of the seats, have all been painted just like the real thing. Apologies for the cut in the video there. I think I should have left the trifle until after this review, but never mind. Anyway, sticking with this review, I shall do some close-ups of the offside and see if I can show you the cab, but going into 5x zoom, actually 6x zoom, you can see from this angle of the model that all the luggage rack and the grab rails and everything inside the vehicle has been nicely picked out, complete with some of the other detail inside the model as well. So, just zooming out again, let's take a look at the separately fitted details on the back of this resin model, which I must point out, by the way, this model is made of resin rather than die-cast metal, so for a resin model, the detail is absolutely phenomenal. And likewise, just homing in on the rear of the vehicle, you've got the destination repeater along with the fleet number at the top, and you've also got the indicators, brake lights and reverse lights all present on the back, just like with the real thing. You've also got some metal wire handrails there, which I believe are grab rails to open the bonnet, of which the bonnet doesn't open on this, by the way. And also, to the left, you've got a tiny little vent grille here. So, if we just zoom out, I shall now turn the plinth around, being careful with this relatively delicate model. And I shall now show you the offside. Starting from the rear to the front, the emergency escape door has been nicely modelled, along with the engine room grille, well, the radiator grille on the offside, which is to the left of the emergency door in this view. You've got the city bus fleet name, along with the gold stripes, and the livery is absolutely nicely reproduced as well. Complete with another view of that beautiful interior. And you've got the Cityflyer logo here, which is both in English and Chinese. I do like the hubcaps, as they've been nicely picked out, along with all this beautiful detailing. You've also got the indicator, and you just get a glimpse of the driver's cab from this view, and the offside wing mirror, as well as the etched luggage rack as well. So if I just take the camera to 7x view, actually I do have a better idea, so just bear with me a moment. I'm just going to move the plinth more to the left and see if I can get a nice close-up of the dashboard from this angle. Just currently homing into 6x zoom, hoping the camera will regain focus. I'll just try again, please bear with me. But just as you can see on your screen, the steering wheel, the dashboard and everything, like you see on the real vehicle, has been modelled on this resin model. So I believe that's all there is to cover on this model. I shall return it to its final position of the front and near side, and then I will give this a perfect 10 out of 10. And you do get a certificate with each model that is issued, although according to the Oriental Model Buses website that I very often visit for references, there is 300 of each vehicle made. So I'm not entirely sure what number of this model would be, but as you can imagine, these are in very limited quantities, so if you want one, you might need to act quickly if you would like one of these in your collection as well. Anyways, that concludes my review. I'm going to give this a perfect 10 out of 10. And this is probably one of the most impressive model buses in the 176 scale that I've covered. So, that concludes my review. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And thank you for watching. Have a good weekend and stay tuned for another video coming soon.